And we're back with part two of Bastion. Let's go. Last time we put down some cores. And what are we building right now? Forge? Distillery?
Whatever you like. I usually go with the forge. I don't like a lot of the spirits at the start. I don't think they're that useful. But it's up to you, man. It's up to you.
Yeah, right now we don't even have enough gold to actually do anything with hammer and bow in hand. With the forge? Like, what can we build with... I don't care about the war machete too much. So I like our configuration of the hammer and the bow. And we're on to our next mission. This game's actually fairly short, but there's a lot of like extras at the end.
Picked up traces of other cores
yeah.
while the kid was out.
Which
I think the challenges are a lot more fun when you don't like fully upgrade your weapon.
Yes.
Which when is you fully kind upgrade of... it. Yeah.
The way that we're doing it, we might upgrade our items.
That's true.
Actually, we could just hit the air one right after this. Let's see how it goes. This is one of my favorite maps. You go into like one of those survival mode. The enemies will keep dropping down, and then you have to survive for a long time. Oh man, you know what? We should have. I really don't like this power or whatever.
Yeah. Oh. I don't know. I never use those.
You don't use your special?
No, like.
Or this one.
I forget which. Like, I hardly use my specials. Like, I even forget they exist.
Man, you're like the true hack and slash.
The only one I liked was you get like a counter spinny thingy, and whenever someone hits you, you just hit them back.
Oh, the mirror
shield. Classic Lumi. Yeah, that one.
That's some legends that
I mean, stuck inside. Yeah, I was doing that no hit run and I needed that. I was like, holy. I'm gonna lie, I spent like 5 minutes on this place hitting all the spiky plants.
Dude, that's the best strat, man.
Because
when the enemy spawn, you have to like run around all day. You gotta take out all this stuff.
Yeah. And then the narrator was like, you can beat those plants up all you want. You ain't gonna get anything. Downright dangerous. Screw you, man.
The narrator don't know us. So when you're full HP, you pick up like these health potions or whatever potions. You get experience instead.
No breaking a cage like that, but the kid tries anyway.
And you know me, I don't get hit, so need those extra pots on the ground. I'm gonna take it for EXP.
He throws a switch. Now what could possibly go wrong?
And this is the,
quite a bit.
This is where Lumi goes freaking light of heaven on everybody.
Cage
right
starts
now.
Lifting from the core.
John Rambo
slow.
Right here.
Look at all that gold.
All kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in.
Well, that's a very bad impression of light of heaven.
No man, Light of Heaven always that first blood. Get first blooded, carry team.
True.
Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while.
I think this part, like, if they didn't have the narrator, this part would be so like boring. But he makes you feel so anxious. Cause he keeps like talking about the time and he's always like, yeah. At times you want to tell him to like shut up, but at the same time you're like...
Nah man, that guy's... Can you say that guy's voice is your caster?
No, not shut up in that sense, but like... You know when... It's like... Man, it's so hard to explain. How do I explain these feels?
you're like, oh my god, I'm dying. Stop telling me.
Yeah, like that.
Heard it pop that mean old foreman.
This is like easy, man. Look at me go, shoot.
And you got help from those dudes.
Yo, I don't even need those dudes.
Maybe 5 more minutes.
Those dudes are fucking hops. Taking my kills.
Oh.
KS machine right now. Oh shit.
EXP hardcore.
Yo man, these the blue goos.
Squirts get real territorial around the core.
Look at that. They don't even know what hit them.
Then a shipment of free sample shows up.
I mean, why are they dropping more plants?
It ain't all bad. A as a kid finds too good. Spices from the
make game harder. Oh, look at that. Lumi went to give that plant a hug.
For sure, that cage is awful heavy.
I'm just walking into like every enemy possible. Holy sh!
Was that the flamethrower?
Yeah,
one?
I just walk into it. It's like, what's up? Shoot. And then he was like, what's up, you?
It's a troublesome scene to be sure.
I really like the grenade one, like, just blow up everybody, roll up to them, drop a grenade.
Yeah, I haven't used, like, half the, well, I already told you, I didn't even know, like, I hardly use those things.
And the core goes free.
I haven't experimented a lot with
that. 9, 8, 7, you give or take a few seconds.
I think some of the later weapons are really cool, like, not as useful, but
and done.
I like the mechanics around it.
I don't know, I find all the items pretty good and useful. Like, they're on an item, there's not a single item in the game where I think it's useful.
Yeah, that's true.
But there's a couple that, like, unless you fully upgrade them, they just suck.
Yeah.
Like the one that, the dart thrower that we got earlier, like, it just doesn't do enough, I feel like. Every soccer played this game, like, a year ago, and I played it, like, last night, so... It's pretty fresh in my mind.
I played it, like November.
I'm gonna collect all my EXP. All right, we're good to go. Okay,
he's got it.
Dodge the cannonball.
That's what I'm good at, man. Where do I get out of here?
I think it's down. Another flying piece of cardboard.
This is your favorite part of the game? Standing on cardboards that go?
Every time. You get on a flying cardboard, like... Man, you tell me the next time in real life you go on a flying cardboard.
Alright.
I still remember the look on his face.
Yo, man, flying cardboard. Everyday appearance.
The old world's finished, but the new world's just getting started.
Alright, here we go. I'm gonna build one more distillery.
Makes time to sample spirits.
What level are you now? I lost track. Are you level 2?
Level 2. Where whiskey is, where I like it. Unless we want to be a, you know, hearty punch, give us an extra life. No, we don't need extra life. We don't die in this game.
Where whiskey has no scent, but tastes like a peppered boot heel, is not for everyone.
Saving gold.
Folks voyage across the boundless sea.
Oh, okay.
Found Ceylandia.
Because the thing just skipped. I thought it froze. It's fine now.
All right, let's go to the proving ground, dude.
I think this is one of the more fun ones if you don't upgrade your weapon.
Yeah.
Actually, this one isn't too affected by it. It's
the
all about position,
used to
timing.
Come here for target practice. Used to play a little game. See who could bust the most targets in the fewest shots.
Wait, I want
to
see how you do this. Because I have a really weird way.
I mean, I don't think there is an optimal way,
armed,
but I don't think it matters.
And he's
too much.
Off.
You just have to get a power shot every time, right?
Yeah, but you gotta do it in 5 hits or less,
yeah.
I think.
Well, I missed my power shot, so...
Perfect shot.
I think you already done good, but...
Yeah, I can't do it. I'm not... Because, the one I use, my regular bow right now, is fully upgraded. So, the timing of power shots different.
True.
What the hell? Let's try one more time, please. If your bow's not upgraded, you have to get a power shot every hit.
Puts on the right solid performance.
Oh man, shots fired. Shots fired. Lumi terrible.
What? Why terrible? What are you talking about? I got second place.
Yo man, you shouldn't have got nothing for that.
What? Haters gonna hate.
Takes practice.
Look at that power shot.
Ooh. Mighty strong bow helps too.
Fuck.
Oh man. Yeah, I always aim for the last one because sometimes you're, even though it looks like you're lined up, it's like, it's pretty messed up.
Yeah, we gotta get the power shots.
Yeah, I think we should just move on.
Should've teared my eyes.
Damn,
actually the first time I did this, I got the first prize after one try. Just like power shot.
Oh. Wow.
Because I stood there and practicing power shot all day, man, on the field. I was mad good with power shots. Alright, let's get more.
That one took me a while.
We'll eventually do all of the proving ground challenges at the end. But now we're let's blow through the storyline.
Couples used to walk the sundown path. Kid ain't here for pleasure though.
I like this place. It's kind of like the.
But then.
First.
Somebody gets to the core.
Do tiles start falling on this place?
Yep.
I think they do. Yeah. Ah.
This
okay.
is so fun.
The floor starts giving way under the lightest step.
This one is quite because you want to like grab all the currency.
That's why you need a fizz, man. Oh fuck.
Be careful, it's the only way to go.
Oh man. Dude, that guy hit you so hard that you like just fell off.
God.
Damn.
No.
That combo.
Well, the path ain't exactly open to visitors no more.
Why is it no going for me?
I think you gotta kill that dude.
Really?
Or do you gotta open the is there a button you press? No, I think you kill the flamethrower guy. Yeah.
You see, the path was intended for leisurely stroll in it.
I don't know, man, I haven't played this in like 2 months. Still best coach.
Sky bridges link the path together. One of them bridges whips the kid along.
Don't fall down, please.
Finds a spyglass.
Yeah, I didn't actually notice that thing the first time. The stars.
This coach.
And you gotta get the upgrade for doing more damage when you fall down.
Cause I freaking fall down master right now, man.
You be tripping nonstop.
Even where the wind blows.
Well, I only fall down if I roll like a champ.
Yeah, that's true. You can actually stop your roll, I think, prematurely if you, like, attack.
Really?
While you're rolling? Yeah.
Oh, look at that! Your stalker coaching right now. Did not know.
Yep, that's what I was abusing. Completely forgot.
Well, if we mastered
yeah, I did the same tactic
the
where
days,
I try to, like, especially if I see the cannon dudes.
But the question
I try to,
is,
like, if I see them at the corner of my screen, I try to shoot them before I actually, like, get into that area. Oh my god. That wasn't even a roll, that was just...
That was just like, gave him a life.
Well,
I was like, oh, that was pretty nice down there.
Scumbag ate it by mistake.
I mean, we could just use hammer roll, but using my special is just faster.
Tough break.
Yeah, the ball actually does an insane amount of damage.
That core ain't coming back.
God!
Holy man, you need a counter for how many times you just fall down.
Yeah, we do. How many times is that so far?
Shit, I don't know. Probably like used to ship live 8 munitions down the path. 9.
Is this the hand grenade?
Yeah, it is.
These wires to toss those things plenty far away.
I actually didn't use this that much, but it seems pretty good.
They get real cranky when you wake them up.
Oh god.
And you I think I usually do there is I stay back and just shoot the thingy.
Man, that ain't us. We ain't doing a no-hit run, we're doing a speed run.
And all this toil, kid keeps
that efficiency.
Back to an overwhelming
this is probably
question.
Like the worst speed run ever when you fall down 8 times.
Who else could have survived the
calamity? Man, later on you're gonna be falling down to do damage.
Yeah, are we really gonna get that upgrade?
Yeah,
that's
the
like the
tactics.
Dumbest upgrade, man.
It's pretty legit.
So he didn't.
You don't actually fall on
time,
top of enemy.
But that ain't about to stop us.
Half the time, right?
No, like, cause you respawn at the edge. So if there's a lot of dudes hugging the edge, but yeah, I think it's kind of useless by the time you get that upgrade. It's not as good.
Do we need to upgrade anything else? Nope. We're just gonna keep going, blowing through the storyline.
We could always see the. They're
gonna man up.
We just never could reach him, no matter how high we build.
Okay, go. Alright, what is this? Visit the forge to switch weapon to find the best combination. I'm waiting for
I've
the
never
shotgun.
Actually...
The dead welcome
the what?
With
the shotgun?
Arms.
Oh. I've never
There's two shotguns.
The calamity took after all.
There's one that, well, let's not spoil it.
Yeah.
Kid sees a plain, frozen faces all around.
Viewers just gotta wait. What was I gonna say? I completely forgot. Oh yeah, I was gonna say that. I've never played an entire, like, stage with two, okay?
I thought that was a path, right?
I'm not gonna lie. I thought that was a path too the first time. Sometimes I would just, like, roll around everywhere just to see if something's a path, because there's a lot of places that you think you can walk to.
You can't.
These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close.
At the same time, you know, you gotta have that inner Dora.
Someone
you gotta explore.
Like Mr. Begbie and his kindly wife. It was someone like him.
Uh-oh. Somebody's alive. What the fuck?
Man, when I saw that dude, it tripped me, like, I was like, holy.
That's like...
It's a snag or two trying to get to
that dude be tripping, man. He's just looking at the sky.
Okay, I'm like surrounded right now. Alright, holy shit.
Dude, that guy's going...
Yo,
your only tactic is to fall off.
Nope, that ain't me. Oh, fuck.
Alright, oh,
got him where I wanted him to be. Look at that. Got into a trap right there.
But you're really tracking questions after all.
Oh man, how did you not fall off?
Yo man, I don't fall off. Counter, easy game, easy life. Oh fuck. Huh.
Just ain't got time for answers. The Tundra brothers didn't make it.
I kind of feel sad that we're, like, killing these guys. Yeah.
I thought I was gonna leave them alone, but I thought there was an achievement if you, like,
kill
them
all.
I was like, do I do the morally right thing or do I go for the achievement?
Didn't make it.
And I was like, eh. I think there's a path down there. I'm not sure. I might be tripping. Nope, I'm tripping. I remember there's one of these places. There's, like, an area down here.
You just want to see me roll down. Yo, look at, isn't that a path?
That's, I've fallen down so many of those. There's actually one of them later on that actually, it doesn't lead anywhere, but it's like one of those paths you can actually stand on.
But him, he survived.
What is this?
Oh, that's what I was thinking of, that thing.
Kid finds proof enough that man ain't from around here.
Whoa.
Another thing that's funny is sometimes you'll see, like, upgrades just, like, floating, and you know there's like a path
just
there.
Without that man,
not upgrades, like the gold stuff.
Right now, would we?
Alright, we're gonna do the restocker tactic. Stay back, shoot stuff. Getting those power shots. Look at that.
When you're in the ghetto, life's hard. Look at all these guys. Helps if you don't miss. Oh, true, you don't use the, Well, the thing is, the shift doesn't help too much anyway when there's a lot of people moving.
Kid does what he has to do. What do you say to a man who's seen too much? Kid hasn't a clue, but he says this. We have to go. Please.
Please. Police!
He's a proper gentleman, that man. His name is Zulf. No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other for the first time.
And we'll be back for the next time in Let's Play Bastion.